Space Dragon and Kim.
Welcome to Pop-Up Particle Quiz, the game show where we figure out who knows the most cool science facts, and whoever knows the fewest amount of facts gets gross stuff dumped on their heads. So 1990s. Let's meet today's contestants. First up, we have Kim.
I better not get slimed because I have a presentation right after this on endoplasmic reticulum.
That sounds endoplasmic ridiculous. Next up, we have Courtney.
If you dump gross stuff on my head, I'm never talking to you again.
And we have Hawking.
Don't even think about dropping poop on my beautiful new shirt.
And as always, our winner goes home with this gold science trophy that I totally just stole from Kim's bedroom.
Hey.
Contestants, are you all ready to play?
Yeah.
I can't hear you.
Yeah!
No, seriously, like, I can't hear you. My ears are full of disgusting earwax. First question. How did some kids wake up on time for school before the alarm clock was invented? A. A person called a clank banger ran around the streets banging pots and pans together every morning shouting, "Wake up!" Or B, a person called a knocker-upper used pea shooters to fire peas at people's windows.
It's B.
Why, yes, give her a point. A knocker-upper shot peas at kids' windows. Next question, true or false? Emus cannot walk backwards.
True, they are literally the worst at doing the moonwalk.
That is correct. Next question, what does the word coprolite mean? Is it A, fossilized dinosaur poop? B, a type of battery used on the Mars rover? Or is it C, a hairy jungle creature closely related to spider monkeys?
It's dino poo.
That is another point for Hawkins. Coprolite is fossilized dino droppings.
I think someone broke my button.
Anyway, it's lightning round time! Pay attention at home, folks. You might learn something here. Ready? Where does gold come from?
Sorry, Courtney. Gold is formed when a star explodes and it vomits the gold out into the universe.
That is correct. However, you pressed Courtney's button, so that's another point for Courtney. Next question. What was the first text message ever sent?
Sup?
No?
Merry Christmas!
Yep, point! Next, define the word zonkey.
Zonkey is a real creature that's half zebra, half donkey. Example, a zonkey escaped from the zoo and stole my nachos!
Yes, hilarious and correct, and also tragic, your poor nachos. Next question! Name an animal that can breathe through its butt.
The Australian white-throated snapping turtle.
That's right! Hawkins and Courtney are head-to-head, and Kim is trailing quite far behind. And now, for the final question, worth 3,000 bazillion points, so anyone could win. Ready? Name this animal. Not quite the answer we're looking for. Anyone else want to try to name this animal?
Yeah, it looks like a Carlos to me. So I'm gonna name this animal Carlos.
You successfully named it! You win! Kim, why don't you hand Courtney her prize?
Alright, that's brutal.
Hawkins, since you won second place, your prize is that you get to step away from Kim, our last place contestant, who's about to experience a little thing I call slimy timey.
I don't like the sound of that.
Well, see you next time on Pop-Up Particle Quiz. Kim, I'm so sorry. I'm not really sorry.
I really gotta go. I'm late for my presentation.